فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. The topic inshallah ta'ala that I'm going to be speaking about in this lecture today is تدبير الله أرزاق العباد. That Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is the one who runs the provision of the creation. He's the one who sustains for his creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the reason why I thought it was important for me to talk about this topic was because of how I saw the Muslims become in regards to making money. Every now and then I travel to central London, and sometimes you end up bumping into the Muslim person over talking and discussing an issue, or you even hear the disbelievers talking. And so what you realize when you're in central London is this place is the place where people are 90% or 80% of the people here are money oriented businessmen, CEO, project managers. So I thought to myself, subhanallah, every conversation that you overhear is about the issue of money, how to make money. And sometimes we forget that this is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And from the 99 names of Allah that we know, the name Ar-Razzaq is from one of his names. Allah is called Ar-Razzaq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names are not just names. In Aqidat Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah, from the belief of Ahli Sunnati wal Jama'ah is Allah's names are A'lamun bi'i'tibari dalalatiha ala al-dhat wa awsafun bi'i'tibari dalalatiha ala al-ma'ani. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's names, they hold meanings. Allah's names, they hold meanings. And those meanings are what Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is. For example, Ar-Rahman, the most merciful. This is the characteristics of Allah. Allah is very merciful, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ar-Razzaq is a name of his, and it means that he is the one who provides. And that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states in the Quran, as he says in Surah Al-Dhariyat, he says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create the jinn nor the ins except to worship me. Allah then says, مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ, I do not want from them. مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ, I do not want rizq and provision from them, and I do not want them to give me sustenance. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ. Rather, Allah is the one who provides, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this ayah is very powerful, or these verses more like, and these ayat are very powerful. If you ponder and you analyze the context in which this ayah was mentioned in, إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ, you realize that the verse before it, Allah was talking about the purpose in why He created you. And as the scholars of tafsir say, السياق من المقيدات, that the context are from the things that restrict the meaning. More like it narrows down the meaning. If there's a verse you don't truly understand what it means, you look at the context and it becomes clear to you what the verse is talking about. So Allah says before, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I did not create the jinn nor the ins except to worship me. So the ultimate goal in why Allah created you subhanahu wa ta'ala is to worship Him alone. As Ibn Abbas said, إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ أي يُوَحِّدُونَ To single Allah in worship. إِفْرَادُ اللَّهِ بِالْعِبَادَةِ To single Allah in worship. That is the purpose why Allah brought you to this earth. That is the ultimate goal. That is the purpose of your life. Then Allah reminds you of rizq, which is something that the human needs and requires. Allah then says to you, مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُم مِّن رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَن يُطْعِمُونَ Allah saying, I don't want rizq from you. So when you're worshipping Allah, you're not providing Him with something. You're not giving Him something. You're not sustaining Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, abadan. You're doing yourself a favor. You're coming with what is needed from you, which doesn't give Allah tabarak wa ta'ala nothing in return. It doesn't increase Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's kingdom, nor does it weaken Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So Allah doesn't need anything from you. He doesn't want you to provide for Him. Then Allah reminds you, no, rather, you. I am the one who provides for you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ Allah is the one who provides for you. Allah is the one who gives you. And this ayah, as I said, it's in the context of what? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّةِ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ If we come with the ultimate purpose in which we were created for, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, that rizq is something I will provide you with. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الرَّزَّاقُ ذُو الْقُوَّةِ الْمَتِينَ And later, inshallah ta'ala, in the lecture, we will, inshallah ta'ala, see examples for this. Examples to prove this. The second point that I want to talk about is the rizq that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has made is large in quantity and is large in amount that you and I are not able to bring an end to it. If we took on all the rizq on the face of this earth and we try to finish it off, it will still remain until the day of judgment. And that is the tafsir of qawluhu ta'ala, إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا Allah tells us, the day of judgment, the earth will shake. Earthquake will happen. إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا And the earth brings out what? It brings out its load. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا The scholars, they mention the Mufassirin, and this is the call of the Jumhur al-Mufassirin, is that وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا means it's kunuz, the treasures, the rizq, that are in this earth will come out. When will this come out? The day of judgment. So the rizq in this earth will come out. And that shows you that the day of judgment will come and there are still rizq. There are provisions. There are kunuz, treasures in this earth which hasn't been used that will come out. Allah tells us, وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا That the earth brings out its load. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا Allah is the one who created for you everything on this earth. He also says, وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا مِنْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ Allah has made easy for you and provided for you everything that's in the samawat and that everything that is on this earth. All of it. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ Verily there are signs in this. لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ For a people who ponder, a people who think, who have intellects. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, أَلَمْ تَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً ومن الناس من يجادل في الله بغير علم ولا هدى ولا كتاب منير. Allah says, do you not see that Allah has provided for you everything that's in the samawat and everything that is on this earth? وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ, and Allah has poured onto you His blessings, ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً, apparent and internally, Allah has poured it all onto you. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ, and from the people are those, مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ, those who argue in the affairs of Allah, بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ, without knowledge, وَلَا هُدًا, and without guidance, وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ, and they don't also have a guiding book. They speak without knowledge and understanding and comprehension and no guidance. After what? After Allah has given them all of this blessing on this earth, all the treasures, all these arzaq that they have on this earth, Allah provided it for them. But with their ignorance, what do they say? Like the atheists, there is no God. They don't worship Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا رَوَاسِيَ مِنْ فَوْقِهَا وَبَارَكَ فِيهَا وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا فِي أَرْبَعَةِ أَيَّامٍ سَوَاءً لِلسَّائِلِينَ وَقَدَّرَ فِيهَا أَقْوَاتَهَا. Allah had destined and He placed on this earth أَقْوَاتَهَا, their provision, their rizq. My beloved brothers and sisters, the seriousness of this matter had become so much that Allah had to swear, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He provides for us and that He's going to provide for us and that the rizq of Allah is not going to come to an end, that the samawat will always produce it, because I just brought an evidence that the earth will always produce until the day of judgment. وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا, but the samawat will also produce crops, it will also produce a rizq for us, like the earth will produce crops for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ لَحَقٌّ مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ. Allah says to us, verily, in the samawat is your provision. In the samawat, there is your provision. وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ, that which you have been promised. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swears, فَوَرَبِّ السَّمَاءِ, I swear by the Lord of the sama, والأرض, and the Lord of this earth, Allah is swearing, إِنَّهُ لَحَقْ, it is true what I am saying, مِثْلَ مَا أَنَّكُمْ تَنْطِقُونَ, like the way you are uttering. The way you are speaking and you are uttering is true, is the same way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what He is saying, it is true. Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said on the commentary on this verse, he said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ أَقْوَامًا, may Allah's curse be upon a people. أَقْسَمَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ, Allah swore for them. Allah assured them and He made an oath, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَلَمْ يُصَدِّقُوهُ, and they did not believe in Him. They did not trust Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, Allah gave us reassurance. First stage is what, my beloved brothers and sisters? The first stage was Allah gave us daman, guarantee that He's going to provide for us. Look what He said. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. Allah says there is no riding beast on the face of this earth except that its provision is on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah mentions this in Surah Hud. And then in Surah Dhariyat, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala swears. He takes it a stage more, not just guarantee, but Allah swears for you. He says, سبحانه وتعالى وفي السماء رزقكم وما توعدون فورب السماء والأرض إنه لحق مثل ما أنكم تنطقون. And then Allah doesn't just stop there, سبحانه وتعالى. He takes a stage further, سبحانه وتعالى. He told you, rely on me, trust me, rely on me, by saying وتوكل على الحي الذي لا يموت, rely on the one who is alive and he never dies. Rely on me, trust in me, believe in me. ولذلك عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه, he narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that he said, لو أنكم تتوكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. If you only relied on Allah the way that the bird relies on Allah. Allah will provide for you the way He provides for the bird. The bird leaves with an empty stomach and it comes back with a full stomach. And Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated this in his Sunan. So that's the stage. Brothers, Ibn al-Qayyim said, فَإِن لَمْ يَطْمَئِنَّ بِضَمَانِهِ If you do not find tranquility in Allah's guarantee, Allah is guaranteeing you, is promising you. If you do not have tranquility and ease at the promise of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, وَلَمْ يَقْتَنِعْ بِقَسَمِهِ And you're not convinced with Allah's oath. وَلَمْ يُبَالِ بِأَمْرِهِ وَوَعَدِهِ And you also do not consider and take into consideration Allah's command and Allah's promise, then you are فَوَمِنَ الْهَالِكِينَ Then you are truly from those who are destroyed. You are truly from those who are destroyed. My beloved brothers and sisters, if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says to you that the provision I'm going to give to you is never going to come to an end, in so large in quantity, I have enough, more than what you can ask for. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says in the Hadith al-Qudsi, narrated by Al-Imam Muslim, on the authority of Abi Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The hadith is very long and it's a hadith Qudsi. Ya ibadi, my slaves, kullukum ja'i'un, every one of you are hungry. Illa man at'amtu, except the one I provide for, the one I give to. Fastat'imuni ut'imkum, ask me for provision and food and sustenance, and I will give it to you. Until the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibadi, my slaves, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا في صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل واحدة مسألته ما نقص ذلك مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أدخل البحر. The Messenger said that Allah said, O my slaves, if the first of you and the last of you, the jinn and the ins, all of you went onto a mountain and you asked Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and Allah gave each and every one of you what He asked for, that will not decrease what is with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, except that which, when a needle is thrown into the ocean, what it decreases, which is nothing. It's the same way that Allah has treasures, it will not decrease. My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He placed and He made the rizq in a way that even if you try to get away from it, it will come to you. There's a hadith al-Imam Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani rahimahullah, ama al-Asbahani, however you want to say it. He said in his kitab, Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiya, and Ibn Asakir also narrated it in his Tariqh al-Dimashq, and Sheikh al-Albani authenticated this, that Jabir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لو أن ابن آدم هرب من رزقه كما يهرب من الموت لأدركه رزقه كما يدركه الموت. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if the children of Adam ran away from their provision, the way they run away from death, then their provision will come to them just like death will come to them. Rather, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he showed it physically, the meaning of this hadith. Because this hadith was what? It is a sunnah qawliyah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did it with a sunnah fi'liyah. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, كُنَّا مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ فَرَأَى تَمْرَةً عَائِرَةً فَأَعْطَاهَا سَائِلًا. Abdullah ibn Umar said, I was with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a date on the earth, and he gave it to a beggar. وَقَالَ The Messenger then said to the beggar, لَوْ لَمْ تَأْتِهَا لَأَتَتْكَ If you didn't come to this date, the date would have come to you. Abu Nu'aym narrated this in his Hilyatul Awliya wa Tabaqatul Asfiya, and Sheikh Al-Albani authenticated it, and Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i also authenticated it. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, in a hadith narrated by Abu Nu'aym in his Hilyah, Al-Bani authenticated it on the authority of Abi Umamah Al-Bahili radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the messenger said, إِنَّ رُوحَ الْقُدُسِ نَفَثَ فِي رُوعِي, that Jibreel blew into my soul. And this is one of the ways that the revelation used to be done. Jibreel came down and he blew the revelation into the Prophet's chest alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is what he said to him, أَنَّ نَفْسًا لَن تَمُوتَ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ أَجَلَهَا, that a soul will not die until it finishes the destined time. Everybody is given a designated lifespan. Until he finishes his lifespan, no one will die. وَتَسْتَوْعِبَ رِزْقَهَا, and until he finishes his provision. So you won't die until you finish your lifespan. And you will also not die until you finish off the rizq that was written for you. Then the messenger said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ, then fear Allah and be conscious of Him and be one who pursues gaining his rizq in the correct way. وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّ إِسْتِبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ أَنْ يَطْلُبْهُ بِمَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ, and do not let the delaying of your rizq carry you to disobey Allah. The rizq is going to come to you, but it might delay. Don't let that delaying make you disobey Allah. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَا يُنَالُ مَا عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِطَاعَتِهِ, for verily, what is with Allah cannot be gained except with His obedience. The rizq is with Allah, and you will not gain what is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except in His obedience. Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim, in his Fawaid, his small book Al-Fawaid, he says, فَتَأَمَّلْ حَالُ الْجَنِينَ, he said, look at the situation of the baby in the womb of his mother. He said, يَأْتِي غَذَاؤُهُ, he said his food comes to him, his meal comes to him, and he's a little child, a little baby, blood, cluster of, in the stomach of his mother. But it comes to him through one source, that is the umbilical cord connected to him and the mother. But when that child comes out of the womb and it comes out into this earth and that umbilical cord is cut, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens for him two other doors. And that is the two breasts of his mother. And through that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gives him rizq. This is his milk and its food, both of them for him. And it is the most tastiest thing for the child. He loves it. Labanan khalisan sa'igan, milk that tastes so nice that he enjoys. فَإِذَا تَمَّتْ مُدَّةَ الرَّضَاعَةِ, when the time of the breastfeeding, حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلَيْنِ, the 2 years is over and it finishes. وَانْقَطَعَ الطَّرِيقَانِ, and the two breasts, comes to an end. Allah تبارك وتعالى فتح له, Allah opens for him 4 طرق, 2, 4 paths. And that is طعامani, 2 food. وَشَرَابَانِ, and 2 fluids. فَطَعَمَانِ, the 2 foods that he gets is حَيْوَانِ وَنَبَاتِ, the animals and the vegetables. وَشَرَابَانِ, the 2 fluids are مِيَاه, water. وَأَلْبَانِ, and the milk. When that time comes to an end, if he had obeyed Allah in those 4, and he feared Allah in those 4, and he made sure he followed the command in Allah in those 4, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala opens for him 8 doors of provision. And that is, هي أبواب الجنة الثمانية, it is the 8 doors of Jannah. يدخل من أيهما شاء, he enters from whichever of those 8 he wishes. And then Ibn al-Qayyim says, نسأل الله من فضله, we ask from Allah's virtue subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He does not prevent us from entering from those 8 doors the day of judgment. And those 8 doors is for no one is not for anyone other than those people who has obeyed Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in the four methods or the four ways that were provided for them. And this statement of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, it goes hand in hand with the statement of Allah, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Anyone who fears Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Anyone who has taqwa of Allah, Allah will make an opening for him. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And Allah will provide for you where you did not expect. This child was provided from places he did not expect. He didn't have no control over his rizq. All of that was the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Sha'biyu Amr ibn Sharahbil, he said on the commentary of this ayah, لَقَدْ رَزَقَنِ اللَّهِ. Allah provided for me. مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا أَحْتَسِبْ. From places I did not assume, أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا رَزَقَنِي مِنْ حَيْثُ أَحْتَسِبْ. More than places I expected. Allah provided me from places I did not expect more than the places I did not expect. Here, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to conclude the lecture with examples. Two examples, inshallah ta'ala, is what I'm going to conclude with. The first one is Maryama, the mother of Isa ibn Maryam, the only woman whose son was named after her. Maryama bint Imran, the mother of Isa ibn Maryam. Allah tells us in the Quran, He says, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَى جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي قَدْ جَعَلَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيًّا وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًّا فَكُلِي وَاشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا فَإِمَّا تَرَيِنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا فَقُولِي إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيًّا. Maryam, Allah tells us, فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ. The time of birth had come to her. She said, يَا لَيْتَنِي. It's a sign of regret. يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا. If only I died before this day. وَكُنْتُ and I was نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا, somebody who was forgotten. Because she knows when she gives birth and she goes out to the community and they see her, they're going to say, where did you get this child from? Who was the father? And they did say that to her. So this is what she was running away from. وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا فَنَادَهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا لَّا تَحْزَنِي. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us, Jibreel called her from beneath. فَنَادَهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي. Don't be worried or concerned. قَدَ جَعَلَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيًّا. Allah has made under you a sari. Sari means a river. A little stream of water that runs beneath, nahar, a little river. Ibn Abbas said, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ, and also move the tree that is next to you. تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطُبًا جَنِيًّا. Dates will come down for you to eat. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, this tree was yabis. It was a fruitless tree. It didn't produce anything. But the minute she touched it, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He brought dates from it, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it poured down for her. Then she was told, فَكُولِي وَشْرَبِي, eat and drink from this which we have. This shows us that Maryama was provided for by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And what it also gives us, this story, is that the Muslim should always work for his, he should work hard. Because Maryama, at this point of her giving birth, Allah didn't say, I'm just going to pour the tree for you and bring all the rizq from you, from there for you. Or it's going to come down from the sky and then it's going to be on a plate for you. I have to work for it. But she came with hard work, which is to trust in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and to believe in Him and to be pious. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب وجد عندها رزقا قال يا مريم أنى لك هذا قالت هو من عند الله إن الله يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. Allah says, every time that Maryam, Zakaria entered onto Maryam, every time he entered onto her, he would find next to her rizq, provision. And he said to her, Ya Maryam, anna laki hada. Maryam, where did you get this from? Qalat, she said, Huwa min indillah. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna Allah yarzuqu man yasha'u bighayri hisab. Allah provides for whoever he wills without any hisab. The second is, and look at Maryam before I move on to the second. The rizq that she used to be given, it was said that she used to get the rizq of summer when it was winter and winter when it was summer. This is something Allah tabarak wa ta'ala did for her. The second one is the story of Ummu Ismail Hajara radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha. Ummu Ismail, who is the wife of Ibrahim alayhi salam, alayhi salam, may Allah be pleased and send salutation on him and his son Ismail. Ibrahim brought her to the desert and he said to her, I'm going to leave you. And she said to him, أين تذهب وتتركنا? Where are you going and where are you going to leave us? In this valley that we're in. الذي ليس في إنس ولا شيء. There's no one here. There's no human being. There's nothing here. فقالت له ذلك مرارا. She said this to him so many times, هجرا. And Ibrahim عليه السلام, he wasn't looking at her. He wasn't looking at her when she was saying this to her, him. Then she said to him, Allahu amaraka bihada. Did Allah tabarak wa ta'ala command you to do this? Qala na'am, he said yes. Then she said a statement that deserves to be written in ink of gold. She said, Idan la yudayyi'un Allah. If that is the case, Allah is not going to abandon us. إذن لا يضيعنا الله. Allah is not going to abandon us. ثم رجعت, then she went backwards. And Ibrahim left her. When Ibrahim was عند الثنية, when he was at ثنية, when no one can see him, حيث لا يرونه أحد, no one could see him. He faced towards, استقبل بوجهه إلى بيت الله الحرام. He faced towards the كعبة. And then he made his dua with his hands lifted up. ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيم الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقوهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون. He said, ربنا, my Lord, إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيم الصلاة. He said, O Allah, I place my family in a valley. There is no zarah. There's no crops next to your house. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ O Allah, so your prayer can be established. فَجْعَلْ مَيْكْ أَفْئِدَةَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ O Allah, تبارك وتعالى, make the people's hearts drawn towards them. وَرْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ O Allah, provide for them rizq, thamarat, crops and seeds and fruits, لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ, so they can thank you. Abdullah ibn Abbas told us that Ummu Ismail, she ran 7 times from Safa and Marwa because she had nothing to give to her child. But when Nabi Ibrahim made his dua, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he sent an angel from high above, and the angel came and he hit his wing on the mountain of Marwa. And then the water gushed out. And then when the water came out, Ummu Ismail, what she started to do was, she started to scoop the water. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, يَرَحَمُ اللَّهُ أُمُّ إِسْمَاعِيلُ لَوْ تَرَكَتْ زَمْزَمْ أو قال, he said, لَوْ لَمْ تَغْرِفْ مِنَ الْمَاءِ لَكَانَتْ زَمْزَمُ عَيْنًا مَعِينًا. The Messenger said, may Allah have mercy upon the mother of Ismail. If only she left the Zamzam water and she did not scoop it, and she did not hold it down, لَكَانَ زَمْزَمُ عَيْنًا مَعِينًا, the water of Zamzam would have overflown. فَشَرِبَتْ, but she drank from this water. وَأَرْضَعَتْ وَلَدَهَا, and she then gave it to her child. This water now became the best water on the face of this earth. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala was controlling her affairs. And when she said, إِذَنْ لَا يُضَيُّعُنَ اللَّهِ, Allah is not going to forsake us. And that she stood by this, and she believed in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَتَوَكَّلُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرُ تَغْدُو خِمَاصًا وَتَرُوحُ بِطَانًا. Leaving with an empty stomach like the bird, and you come back with a full stomach, relying on Allah when you go out. But we're being put in a society today where we fully trust and believe ourselves. We only rely on the means. And we tend to forget that the results are in the hands of Allah. But what we're taught in our religion is, the means is what we come with, but we rely on Allah. We know that the means can be, it could be paused by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. تَعْطِيلُ الْأَسْبَابِ, the means can be brought and it may not work. And we saw that. Have we not heard of the story of Nabiullah Ibrahim when he got burnt? Isn't a fire what burns? But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, they came with the means to burn him. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he done what? تَعْطِيلُ السَّبَبِ, he stopped the sabab from working. You see, how many people did things that if they do, they would die from it. But they did it and they didn't die from it. They threw themselves from a far building, but they didn't die. All of this, it shows you that the sabab is what you come with. Lakin the final result is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So remember that. And also remember, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. Fear Allah in your rizq and what you put in your body. Perfect what you pursue. Correct it. And make sure you pursue what is permissible for you. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.